Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-365. Today's episode, I'm going to be covering some of the top findings that I've had leveraging Microsoft 365 Copilot over the past few months here. And keep in mind, our entire organization is not leveraging this product yet, just a subset or handful of users. A lot of that has to do with experimentation, but more so along the lines of the data privacy and security concerns as well, which I believe any organization should have going into the genesis of this offering. So today I'm mostly going to be covering all this in demo format across the office suite, such as Teams and Outlook and everything like that, giving you the pros and cons of each or what I've been seeing, just leveraging it within our organization. In the future, though, I'll also be covering some more content around SMB AI readiness as well, too, because I feel like a lot of the content being generated today, as usual, is enterprise focused. And I think there's just a different talk track when we talk about SMB, the data management, the business practices, everything like that. So stay tuned and subscribe to the channel if you're not already. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive into some demos. Okay, first things first, gonna start off with Microsoft Teams here. This is where I think that Copilot is actually a rock star in the sense of the functionality and everything it does. You can do meeting recaps if you hit the transcribe and record button while you're in that meeting, and it captures these meeting notes that I feel like are really accurate and completely succinct in the sense of the bullet points of capturing all the topics. So even if you don't make the meeting, you can really go in and see what was covered pretty clearly. And it also captures follow-up tasks as well. So you can clearly see, you know, what needs to be done from a responsibility layer. It's got all of your content in here that's been shared as well over time. And the other cool part is that you can just go right into the Copilot side menu here and you can ask it even more questions. So I could say something like, what product are we talking about in this video? And this is on the fly demo, so I don't know what's going to respond to here, but this is going to be something that it's really analyzing that transcript and looking in and saying, okay, we're looking at Quest, which is our platform internally here, which is really cool. And it's summarizing more of what they're covering about that application as well. So really cool functionality. I found this to be really accurate. One of the more powerful aspects that you can demo and showcase as well too on your calls as a sales rep, because you can get on a call and record that with your customer and then show them the output. And it's really mind blowing to see that actual recap. The main interesting thing about this, as a sidebar, is that this functionality is also available with Teams Premium, which is a significantly less cost than Copilot. So just want to call that out. Could be a starter or gateway into getting into the broader licensing that doesn't have such a financial burden. So the next thing I want to show here is Outlook and just email in general. So this is a use case where I've been forwarded an email thread with multiple participants and everything like that. And I quickly just want to summarize what this thread is about. And when I click on Summarize by Copilot, it does that, has all the necessary parties involved, but it also does a really succinct job of making this really condensed in the ways of which I would want to read that quickly, going through all my email over time as well. So pretty cool functionality there. But when we talk about new email and kind of the draft that it can do here, I don't know that I love this experience just yet, mostly because it's pretty generic and it hasn't captured really my voice, at least not yet, for what I would want to say. So I could say something like, draft an email that asks for timesheets and new designs from my fellow product manager. And when I click on generate here, you'll notice as this populates, this is still pretty fast, but it says some things like, I hope this email finds you well, which is something that I would never say. I think it's a waste of typing, honestly, if you get into that. But this is something where it's actually drafting that, and it's probably not the best use case as far as the example goes, but it can do a really good job about adding changes such as the temperature in the sense of your voice, and like it's more aggressive, it's nicer, something like that. So you can mix this up a little bit and keep generating, but I haven't found like a lot of use case for this internally yet, just because I don't think about that. I think it does a better job in trying to respond to emails if you give it a little bit of context to save you a couple seconds maybe, or maybe a minute if it's a lengthy email. But I don't feel like I'm going to be using this a lot at this point in time to draft new emails for the things that I'm looking to do. But again, this is just experimentation. This is just how I'm adopting. I could be prompting it wrong as well too. So like that, email as a whole does pretty good job, but we'll shift in here into chat to see more of the email summarization, more of the broader expansion here too. Okay, so this is Microsoft 365 Copilot Chat. I think it's a very interesting tool. It's actually what I like to use the most personally outside of the Teams meeting recap, just because it can do a lot of great investigation across your Teams, your shared folders, your Outlook environment, all of your email, things like that. So one of the common, most common things that you could ask it is to summarize your email over the past X time period. And you'll see that this takes a minute to generate, but we're talking about maybe 10, 20 seconds to really go through all my emails over the past 48 hours and really generate a bulleted list of the things that I've got in my inbox. And this is interesting. This is, again, a live demo, so I'm not making this up or video editing or anything like that. So this is saying, oh, let me get more specific, and it has this dialogue with you. So I'm going to say all my emails for this question, because it's just asking, do you want to do all of them or maybe some? Now, again, I blurred this out for privacy, but I've highlighted one of the top ones there, which is really giving me that action item of a summary, and it goes through a bolded list there. So that's a really cool feature that I have. And I could also do things like, give me all the emails sent by XYZ person over the past 2 weeks, and it will summarize that as well too. So if you have a manager that you report up to, you want to understand, what do I need to follow up on that I may be forgetting, or vice versa, you can do that within this context. The other thing, though, that I thought was interesting, this is getting into the data privacy conversation, is that I can start to probe and ask for documents that may exist about a certain topic. So I can say something like, provide me any documents or chat conversations that relate to live chat. And this is just a lively topic for us right now, from the things that we've been doing, but it's actually going through and looking at all of not only your documents, but also any document that you do have access to, which is really interesting, because if you have access to documents in shared locations, it's also going to be pulling up those as well. Now, I skipped ahead here just to not have you watch all this all being typed out here, but this is where I found that there was something interesting, which is that there was a document in here about live chat that I didn't know existed, and it's in a shared environment that I have a membership into. So whether or not I was put into that actual Teams channel is suspect, because I don't really need to be in there after investigating. But the cool part is you also have the citations in here as well, which shows me where that document lives. And this is, again, it's cool, but it's also the scary part about the technology, because it is getting into the fact that you need to have a data governance strategy before you really implement this, because that's just where people could go in and find documents they don't really need to be seeing, that have really sensitive content about either users or the organization, IP, things like that. And that's where this gets pretty scary, and where we have to have a readiness plan if we're going to need that, or we're going to have this laid out into the entire organization in the future, because they could be some pretty scary documents. You could end up finding a document with everybody's salary on it, right? And that's pretty concerning when you think about this. And I think that's the real issue today with Copilot. It's not in the sense that it's a problem you can't overcome, but we should be most concerned about insider threat and being able to find information that we don't really need access to, which could lead to data exfiltration. So just wanted to call that out as well, just because it might be a more common use case. But this is something that I thought was both really powerful, because you can search through everything basically to find, and it's indexed all of your data. But again, we have access to things in this case that I didn't need or should have access to in that relative use case. Okay, shifting into Word here, this is also a really powerful experience, especially with lengthier documents. You can really just ask it to summarize the document. A lot of summaries are very commonplace with everything that we're doing within Copilot. But then you could also go into the draft mode here, which allows you to describe what you want to write here. So I could say something like, write me a bulleted list describing a proposed AI strategy. You can reference it here, and you can have it start to generate here. So it goes through a quick little learning process, and it puts out these bullet points for me as well, which is really powerful as well too, if I'm helping me draft certain content within the Word doc that I might want to leverage, or at least experiment with, to see it would beef up my content and the things that I'm trying to propose. So a lot of these things, I think, again, if you start off with just summarizations and things like that, I think that's really powerful. More of the draft level content outside of the things that you might be doing in Outlook may be a little bit slower to adopt, in my opinion, because that's not my first go-to when I think about drafting a document. Maybe cleaning it up from a grammar standpoint, but also just from an organizational standpoint so that it reads better. It can also do that as well too. PowerPoint is next. Again, another one where I don't feel like I'm going to be adopting this too much because I'm just going to be leveraging my deck. But one cool thing that it does here is you can create a presentation even from a file, so like a Word document, and you can craft a new message that way, which I'll show you here in a second. But I could just say, you know, create a presentation on a proposed AI readiness strategy. And when I do that, it's gonna take a minute and it's going to work on actually generating slides with pictures and graphics and everything like that, which I think is really interesting. So here's the final output of that, and it generated this presentation. I do think some of the graphics don't make a ton of sense, and you'll see that probably more with the upload that I'll be doing here as well. But it's decent, you know, and it gives you some structure that you could work off of as well. But for me, again, I think I'm gonna be leveraging kind of more of a cleanup than a net new generation of slides. But the other thing that you can have here is you can copy the URL for a sharing link from a Word doc, for instance. It can generate a whole PowerPoint slide based off of that Word doc as well. So I'm going ahead and pasting in a link today, and I'm going to be sharing out. And this is the other cool thing from an intelligence layer that I thought was really interesting as well too, which is to say that maybe you want to create a saved document of what you already have and not wipe that away. So it does have some intelligence behind that level of functionality if you do already have slides within your PowerPoint experience there. So then it goes through and it looks at kind of the high level, it's kind of summarizing the document as far as what it wants to create into the slides. And then you'll notice that it generates the slides on the fly here and gives you the progress bar as far as the percentage goes of completion. Additionally, it's really interesting that it adds the speaker notes there as well. So I think, you know, this is pretty interesting to see, you know, the output of this. And some of the metrics, again, the pictures are a little bit off today for me from what I'm seeing. Like this before when I did this, prior to doing this demo, showed a picture of people playing soccer. So it wasn't really that accurate in that sense. But again, I think those are more smaller cleanup items, and a lot of it has the core for what you would want to do. I think you would just want to maybe incorporate your marketed or marketing approved slides there as well. But quickly just spinning up a slide deck in general is pretty interesting. And it's really cool that it just captures the entire Word doc there for the things that you want to portray. So last one I just want to portray is Excel. This is not something that I adopt more so just because I'm not a user who uses Excel every day. It does a really good job with formulas, and I used to do that in ChatGPT, and now I can do it with more of an integrated experience. But it also does a really good job about indexing this data and summarizing data that's in tables as well. So this basic product list in a table here, and it has certain columns such as the category, but I can easily just click into the table and say, show me data insights. And it's gonna go ahead and analyze that table and try to build out some type of a graphic as well. And in this case, it gave me a pivot chart that shows me, you know, out of all the items in this list, the license appears the most, which is a really interesting insight because I don't have any of that information. I just have rec IDs and then I have categories for this, but I can add this to a new sheet and it gives me this whole pivot table and visual of the top categories based off of the counts. And I didn't have to do anything myself. Not that this is overly complex, but again, we're saving ourselves probably a couple minutes if we didn't already know how to create this. Like if you're using Excel and you don't know how to use a pivot table, it's even exponentially more powerful. But this is just quick insights that we can get about the data that don't take much time at all. And you can just probe it with other things that you would want to see in there as well too. So I think a lot of people are going to be using this for more of the complex formulas, things like that. But for the layman, it gives you a really easy way to kind of visualize your data and get charts out of it, which is something, the charting piece of it's not something that I'm more versed in. Certainly the formulas and things like that, but very interesting to see this as well too. Okay guys, that's everything I have for you today in this demo video of Microsoft 365 Copilot. Hope you learned a little bit more. Definitely comment below with what you're most excited about. If you have any questions related to the product offering, again, like I mentioned, I will have more content coming out related to SMB readiness and just probably deep diving more on some of the feature set after getting more exposure. So thank you guys again. Subscribe to the channel if you have not already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.